two are bad friends.
Who are these two idiots?
A white dude and an Asian dude.
You two are disgusting.
Well, you two are something.
We're bad friends.
Welcome back to Bad Friends, baby. Are we rolling?
We are rolling.
Huh?
We're rolling.
Are we rolling?
Rudy Jules is here.
Hello. Hey, everybody. I'm a big fat liar. Andrew.
Yeah, Bob.
Blah, blah, blah.
Oh, you're the worst. Let me start this off the way that he had it on the show here. Let me
see okay. Hell yeah.
Welcome back to Bad Friends.
You should have pulled your dick out and just...
Here's the real Bad Friends. Welcome back to Good Friends. We're here with Rudy Jules is back in town.
Good friends, huh?
Me and Eric Griff are back, baby.
Wait, we're going to be good friends or we have to be like...
best friends.
Some sort of bathroom utensil brothers? How about we be like the toenail clipper cousins?
Toothbrush bros. Whatever. Rudy, where were you?
I was in Hawaii.
I can't hear you. Is her mic not on?
You went to Hawaii?
No, her mic's not on.
How much are you paying this chick?
Hold on
this
one second.
This is ridiculous.
Hold on.
So what were you guys doing before I got here that this shit isn't ready to go?
100%. That's exactly correct.
What's going on?
George was sitting there in the seat. But by the way, George is back. George is sitting in the seat doing nothing. Go ahead and test it out.
Hello. There
now we can hear.
So you board the plane and then they're like, oh, you know what? The wings.
Yeah.
Something's up with the wings, mm-hmm. So we can't fly yet.
What were you doing?
Yeah, what the fuck are you guys doing for the past?
I just came back from New York and they, it's so funny because they were like, we have to clean and disinfect the plane. We clean and disinfect the plane before everybody gets on it, right? They say that every time. The plane parked, people got off, within seconds, they boarded that bitch. I was like, they didn't.
I know. Did you clean it?
They didn't clean it.
Did you?
Did you know? There's a dude like, he's like, they're good. They're good. Get on.
No, it's like, have you seen them?
They're not cleaning anything.
They're spraying some sort of like disinfectant.
I've seen it.
Yeah, I feel like we're like corn. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? Because they just, come on.
We're gonna grow ears and noses,
man.
And shit.
I think that's the thing, and they're really adamant about like the filtration system. And don't worry, we're basically when you get on a plane, you're basically saying, look, I may or may not get COVID, but I need to get where the fuck I'm going.
Yes, like, that was the whole point.
That's what this is about.
I know.
This dog and pony show for someone else.
There was a woman who complained about the middle seats not being open. I talked about this, and I was like, you got on the tube with strangers. You have you're done.
Yeah.
No rights. It's over.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
You can't complain about the middle seats. This was a month ago too. The middle seats are supposed to be blocked off. She was like, "Ma'am, that's as of the first. We're filling in all the seats now."
Yeah.
She was like, "That wasn't on the ticket, Dada." And she's like, "Ma'am, you can leave. You can get off.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Or
you
can go to Atlanta."
Yeah.
What do you want to do?
You know, this is the same feeling I have about like people don't understand that you have a social contract.
Yeah.
When you get on a plane.
Yeah.
Like, so you're getting on the plane with others.
Yeah.
So you don't get to act like this is your private jet. Bitch, this is Delta, okay? And you got other people on the plane. And I can't stand when people act like, oh, you know, it's like, no, man.
Yeah.
I even feel the same way about like apartment living. Like when you're living in an apartment, you have a contract with these other people who live here. There's going to be noise. There's going to be people are going to be walking around.
Coming and going.
People are going to be coming and going.
Yeah.
The people that act like, oh, you're making too much noise. Hey, go buy go buy 6 acres of land someplace, bitch. And
get out.
And get out.
Get out.
But when you're living here, shut up.
Yeah, like, shut up.
I couldn't agree more. Turn my music up louder. Fuck you. It's like 3 o'clock in the afternoon, like whatever it is.
Excuse me, sir. The music is loud.
Yeah, it's like you're living with other people.
Right.
We're basically all living in the same house.
Right.
That's what an apartment is.
Yeah. You can't complain. That's the problem. You can't. Once you live with other people, you learn. And if you hate it that much, get out. Move far away.
Check this out, too.
You live in a city. You live in one of the most dense cities.
Yeah.
What do you want me to do?
This is what's going to happen. There's noise.
Right.
Imagine Bill Gates and Melinda Gates.
Rest in peace.
They live in like a 300-acre like mansion, right? They literally could live in the same house and never see each other. Uh-huh. And these motherfuckers still was like, I got to get away from you. She was like in the other part of the estate. There's servants and there's robots and shit. Yeah. You could be in your own area.
They don't exist
together.
And she's
in this mansion like this. I can't stand him. Imagine living like, you know, you in a two bedroom apartment in Reseda.
She's putting out the woodwork. Do you know about this? She's got her lawyers going in on him. Her lawyers are trying to find, they're like, and there's photos of him with Epstein. And like, they're trying to clip him every angle, man.
How much money of his money does she need?
Well, here's the trick with her. She's giving it all away. Have you seen this?
I didn't get a piece of it.
Search how much money Melinda Gates has given away.
Well, they both have given away money.
I know, but this is her goal. I think she wants to take all of his shit just to give it away. That's revenge.
Like the OJ people?
Yes, bro. Yes.
She want to be in front of the courthouse burning his money?
Look at that. Well, where is it? It's just Melinda Gates, though. If you can see what she's given. She has this big philanthropic need to give away all of his money. And she said, her half that she got from him, she's going to give away like 80% of it. She wants all of it gone.
Check it out. Ooh.
Right.
Oh, you're going to give away 80% of $50 billion? Like, go fuck yourself, man. Like, she acts like it's like, oh, I'm putting myself out and right. I'm giving away. I'm only going to have like $3 billion left.
Right.
Like, fuck off, lady. Fuck off.
I want to see them. I put it all into Bitcoin and then we'll see what happens.
No, I want to see the person that has only like $10,000 and they go, I'm giving all my money away to charity. That means something.
Yeah, that does. You're right. You're right. Well, what can you even do with all that money?
You have to give it away.
The foundation spent $5 billion in 2019 on programs in the United States around the world, including management costs from 94 to 18. They've given away $36 billion. Yeah, that's not what I was looking for. But anyway, I do know she's trying to give away all of his money, which I think is a bad bitch move. She's like, fuck this dude. I'm going to bury him. I'm going to give away all his money.
Wait. My thing is like this. What does she think the relationship was going to be like? First of all, he's a crazy nerd.
So is she, right?
Right, but he's got like all this money.
Mm-hmm.
Like you think he was going to be regular husband? I got $50 billion. Give me $50 billion. Me and Rachel going to have a whole different relationship.
I give you $50 billion, you go, Rachel? Rachel, who's Rachel? Who's Rachel?
No, I'd still be with her, but she would be like, you know, on the other side of the...
And then she'd leave you and take your half. Yeah, that's what happened. That's right. Rudy, where did you come back from, Rudy?
Yeah, you went to Hawaii.
Welcome back, Rudy.
Hi.
You look tan.
Do you miss Bobby?
Yeah. No.
No. No way. I want to tell you about my Bobby called me the other day when I was in New York. I'll tell you about
it's
but
all
I want
lies.
I want to hear about Hawaii. Did you have fun?
Yeah, we went diving, snorkeling, and hiking.
Yeah? Did you catch any fish?
No, we didn't.
You didn't spear any fish? Weren't you guys...
Hold on,
Las Vegas, but not in Hawaii.
Oh, I thought you did that in Hawaii, too.
Hold on a second. Oh. Hold on a second. Can you tell me about... Okay, all that boring shit you just said? Tell me the good stuff. Did you meet any dudes? Did you, like, you know...
Look at her face.
What happened? Was there a pool boy flirting with you?
It's a strict rule that it's a no-dude policy. And if she did meet somebody, she knows she can't say it in front of me because Papa Santino doesn't put up with that. She's not dating until she's 30.
But I met
30?
35, you're right. What did you say? Did you meet somebody?
I was in the post office today to mail something.
You see what you've done to her?
I know.
She went to Hawaii, a beautiful setting, couldn't meet a dude.
Yeah.
At the post office, she met a guy.
No, but there was a guy and he was cute and then he asked me if I was Rudy.
Really?
Yeah.
And what did you say?
Yeah.
Yeah, and?
And then he said I was doing good in the podcast.
Okay, and?
Mm-hmm.
And I said bye.
She's genius.
Cut to them in the back of the room.
No, she knows. She says, yes, thank you, leave me alone. You should have made him pay for your shipping. What were you at the post office for?
I was returning my dress from prom.
Oh, do we have
returning
pictures of that?
It.
No.
Come on.
I have pictures in my Instagram of my dress.
Oh, you do?
Who'd you go to prom with?
Myself.
Like a boss. How was prom?
It was really fun.
What did you do? What happened? Give me some prom stories. Ooh, Rudy. Woo! Rudy looking sharp, dude. Look at that. You in that dress. That's fancy. That's cool. It's like tie-dye.
Yeah.
Was it a themed prom? What was the...
No, there was no theme.
Really? Didn't we used to do themes?
Yeah.
I feel like that was a thing.
Well, your thing was always like casino night at your high school, I'm sure. It was like...
And yours was in the 40s, so that was just real for you, old ass bitch. Don't talk about me. When did you graduate high school again?
Yours was... No.
Be for real. When did you graduate high school?
Prohibition. It was like...
It's always a drunk thing.
Yeah.
Yeah. They're like, that's not the theme. 90. I'm like, yeah,
I graduated in 90.
1990. Yeah. When were you born?
2001.
Jesus Christ.
You could have had two families by the time she was
born. I know. Yeah, I have. Yeah, yeah. Live in a different state. So I have to like fly back and forth.
Right. You were a traveling salesman.
Yeah.
Smoking on airplanes. Rudy, you look great. That's such a nice photo. And you took yourself, right?
Yeah.
Why? Did you not get asked?
Yes, and I also didn't want to be with a guy.
Okay, we have to go. We can't let this go. Okay.
Did you want to go with a girl instead?
No.
Okay, well, you just said it like that. Don't know me like that. You went, I didn't want to be with a guy. That sounded very literal. It was about a guy. Yeah. You just didn't want to go with somebody.
Yeah, I just wanted to be with
Wait, friends. Wait, why? Why the guy that asked you, why?
There's
no
be
eye candy you could have brought with you?
Why is it going to be awkward?
Because I don't know how to like interact with them.
What do you mean? Yes, you do.
This is because of you people.
This is not me. This she lives people. In Bobby's
she
house.
She don't even know how to deal with me because she thinks men are you and Bobby. Like,
no.
Imagine.
No.
Imagine it. Her example of men is you and Bobby.
We're uncles. Ugh. We're her uncles, okay?
Ugh.
She knows how to deal with boys.
That's why she at the post office like, oh, hey. She was in Hawaii and couldn't find nothing in the post office. She was like, oh.
Maybe she doesn't want to find a dude, right, Rudy? See? She's independent, bro. Because, she doesn't need that.
Because you've scared her.
That's right. Bringing no boys around this studio.
I guess it worked.
Yeah, but you know what, Rudy? I think that's cool that you went alone. That's a smart move. Eric went alone, but that was not by choice. That was just because ain't nobody gonna ask your ass.
You should. Okay, I'm going to bring That's my prom not, pictures.
Okay, I want to see it.
You got to see the dime piece I went with.
I want to see it. I do want to see. Did you?
Yeah.
Yeah?
Prom was fun.
What did you do? What was your prom like?
I don't even remember, dude.
I barely remember that stuff. So wait, you went to Hawaii. You had a bunch of fun with Kalila and her sister, right?
Mm-hmm.
And then you came back. You went to prom. You killed it at prom. No Hawaii pictures, by the way.
Mm-hmm.
No.
Why?
Well, you don't want to see the real things that happen.
No, they don't want to show off how fancy she is because they were probably staying in the Four Seasons and all that stuff. You know what I mean? With suites and stuff.
I know.
Richie Rich over here.
I know.
Who did you hang out with at the prom? Do you have a group of friends?
Yeah, I have. And then this girl was so high that she was becoming annoying.
What was she on?
I don't know. She just smoked something.
She smoked something and just was becoming
annoying.
Yeah.
Yeah,
That is annoying.
Their generation. I was in Best Buy yesterday picking up a little card, and these girls at the register were probably same age, like 19, 20, you know, whatever, and were losing their minds because a dude, I don't know, you may know, Charli D'Amelio's boyfriend was there. Do you know who that is?
Noah Beck.
Noah Beck? Is that his name?
Wow.
Yeah.
She pulled that out of her.
Well, that's what I said. It was like the same age. Bro, well, they couldn't check me out because this guy was in the store. The store was shut down for this cat. People were losing their minds for this dude. I never heard of him in my entire life.
Yeah.
I know who she is, the TikTok girl. Is that him?
I think. Wait, that's Dixie's boyfriend. I don't know about Charlie's boyfriend.
See, look at they. I knew she would know.
I just don't get it.
What do you mean you don't get it? He's a like a hunky, hot, young dude. What do you mean?
Yeah, but there's probably like 1,000 that look just like him.
I know,
what's
but
the,
he's probably
what's the appeal?
He has a famous on YouTube or some shit.
Oh, okay.
They all got to have the same level of fame to date each other.
I get that.
That's the kid. That was him. That was him. Long hair. That was him. Yeah, the other one didn't look like him. That was him. What's his name?
Chase Hudson.
I love when George. Yeah. You're Chase Hudson.
I know. Just
I
like
love
the
George.
Dorkiest.
I love the dork. He's such a dork. I love him.
Like those two guys, that would be a great sitcom. The Dracula and
Dork and Dorkier.
Yeah. Like that would
Dracula and Pink Dick.
Like if they were gay, that'd be a great like you know
if?
Like yeah.
If
I George, I want to take you out on a.
I like how you mistake. I like how you mistake. He's from Spain, but you think he's from Transylvania.
Well, the way he's got a little Transylvania in there.
Yes, he does.
He's like, I want to go. To
no, that is a good call because when I mock him, when I go finance advice.
Yeah.
It does kind of sound Transylvanian. He might be. Do you think Fancy B might be a vampire?
I think so.
Yeah.
Yeah.
He does kind of exude some of the qualities. He stays up all night.
He's really.
Right?
He's probably 700 years old, and we don't realize it.
Nah. I see some signs of his age for sure.
No, because you know what? If you were, let's say, you really were a vampire.
Mm-hmm.
People would notice you. You couldn't be on Instagram. Like, to really survive, you got to be a dork. You know what I mean?
You have to be, well, dude, who edits, you know, at night and
nobody really knows him. You know what I mean? Because no one's going to be like, oh my God, you look like somebody I met when I was a little kid. Like, no, he's just going to be like a, you know, an introverted, like.
It's true. An editor. He sits in a dark room. Yeah. Don't you, fans? You sit in a dark room editing all day and all night, don't you?
That's my life.
That's my life. And I don't really know. And I don't really know. His wife isn't real. We've never seen her. You know that, right? Never. Mm. No one knows who she is. George, have you ever seen his wife?
I think it was a plant, though. You know, she was way too attractive for him.
Yeah, it was a beard. It was a pay.
It was a hire. He hired her.
Hired her, yeah.
I have her in the basement.
Oh, in the basement.
I have her in the basement.
I have her in the basement.
I've made him across.
Which is basically just his apartment.
Right. I live in a basement. I live in the basement. She lives with me. Click on the first photo of this guy.
Look at this guy.
Chase,
you know what?
Hudson. Do you like him, Rudy? Is he good looking? He's not. Not at all. No. What about him do you not like? Because he seems like he's a cute guy. Am I wrong?
He's a little androgynous, too. I think that's the people.
What, he seems like he might be a chick and a dude?
Yeah.
What do you what do you not like about this guy, Rudy?
I've just seen him a lot in TikTok.
Oh, you know. Okay, so you
So you're annoyed by him.
Yeah, that's what.
But you don't find him attractive?
Well, that's like, well, I guess that makes sense, though, because if you do see someone enough and they just piss you off, you're like, I can't stand this.
Who do you find attractive?
Of these guys, these young famous guys.
Who's the guy that you go, ooh?
Who is on your Tiger beat? Yeah. I have no idea what that is.
I like Vinny Hacker.
Vinny Hacker.
Let's see.
Not his real name for sure.
If it is, wow.
He looks like the same guy.
Fucking guy.
That's the same guy.
Wait a minute.
No.
He's even more gay, this one.
I like it.
This guy, what do you like about this guy? Looks just, pull up a side by side of this guy and the other guy.
The same guy. That's the same guy.
They are the same guy. Look at that.
No.
Same guy. Same guy. That's literally if you said to me, is that the same guy? I'd go, yes, of course that's the same guy.
They look exactly alike.
They do. No. Who does Vinny Hacker date, Rude?
No one.
Well, could be Rudy Jules. Reach out to him on the gram.
No.
Why not?
Look at this guy's lips.
How old is this? That's injections for sure.
Is he getting his lips injected? Jesus.
It's weird nowadays.
He's got some juicy lips. I've been like, what's up, girl?
Guys. How do guys have DSLs now? That's a big thing.
Yeah.
Boys have DSLs. Like, that's insane.
I get it. Look at this.
Yeah, but that's all manufactured, right? He's not born like that. That looks like, those are women lips.
Yeah, like, how does he, like, I would just like to see him, like, on a Tuesday, like, at 4 p.m., just regular, because this looks all.
Well, okay, scroll down. Let's see if there's,
this
like,
this is all made up stuff. Let's, like, see, look, if there's, at this just guy. Is he ever normal?
I mean, on the far left, that was him. Top left, that one. Yeah, that looks like it's just in the during the day randomly, right?
No, he still looks like
he's still posing.
Yeah, he's posing. He's done up at all times.
But that's his whole.
You understand, Rudy? This is all fake.
No, this is real.
I'm saying, like,
don't ruin my fantasy. Scroll down. This is all fake. You're right, though.
Yeah,
he
looks exactly like the other guy.
But let her have Vinny Hacker. All right. She likes Vinny Hacker.
So you're into white guys like this.
No brown for you, huh?
Mm-hmm. I like brown.
Wait. Who was that for? That's like, is your family watching and they just went like this?
Yeah. I like brown.
I like brown. I do. I love brown.
Yeah, but every guy you've mentioned on the show that you think is cute has been a white guy. Yeah.
Okay, this one. Manny from Good Girls.
Manny from Good Girls. What's Good Girls? Is that a Netflix
show? Yeah.
I never heard of it.
I'm thinking of a different show. Good Girls is a great show.
Oh, that him, right? That's him? So you like Manny?
Yeah, he's hot.
He's hot. Yeah, no, he is attractive. I think you're right there.
Yeah, so if...
He kind of looks like Travis Barker with that beanie.
But what I'm saying is the brown guys she likes have to be like...
Very light-skinned.
In Mexican cartel type of like bad boys.
Right.
But the white guy could just be like, hi, I'm white with big lips. You know what I mean?
Yeah, hi, I'm white with big lips.
This is actually a great show. I like this show.
Good Girls?
Yeah.
What's it about, Rude?
Moms that are stealing stuff.
Oh, I've seen the preview of this.
Yeah.
Somebody who's really famous that's in it. It's one famous lead, right?
I don't think she's all that famous.
No, yeah, she is. There's one. I've seen the poster of it.
These are the people.
Well, Christine Hendricks. I know Mae Whitman. She's a great actor. She's really dope. Oh, and yeah. Retta, you know Retta.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. But they're just, you know.
Yeah, but Christina.
They're great. But they're
Christina,
all great. It's a great show.
Mae Whitman is very. She's dope. I think she's really talented.
I watched that show.
I should watch it. I've seen the billboard. I've just never. Mm-hmm. I never checked it out. BetterHelp. Hey, Bob and I have talked about this so much on this show. I know you've heard it if you're a fan of the show. We are both big proponents in mental health help. That's what we like. And BetterHelp is the way to get that done. You can start communicating in under 48 hours.
It's the best. It's like, it's so easy. You can, under 40. And it's not a crisis line. It's not self-help. It's professional counseling done securely online. It's so easy.
These are professionals that are here to help you. I do love talking to someone. I think it eases my mind. It helps me get through the day. And let me tell you something. You do it from the comfort of your own home.
No matter where you are in the world.
All you need to do is log on from literally anywhere. The service is available for clients worldwide. They have a broad range of expertise.
You'll feel much better. You'll be much happier if you use this service, guys. Visit their website and read their testimonials that are posted daily, okay?
At betterhelp.com/reviews. Once you go there, you can see the other people that have gotten the help that they need. And we want you to get help as well. To talk to someone about whatever you got going on. Doesn't matter how big or how small. BetterHelp is here to help you. Visit betterhelp.com/badfriends. That's BetterHelp, H-E-L-P. Join the over 1 million people who have taken charge of their mental health with the help of an experienced professional.
So many people have been using BetterHelp that they are recruiting additional counselors in all 50 states.
This podcast is sponsored by BetterHelp, and Bad Friends listeners get 10% off their first month at betterhelp.com/badfriends. betterhelp.com/badfriends.
Upstart!
Hey, when it comes to paying off debt, it can feel like an uphill battle. I know. Bobo and I were both in heavy debt when we both started comedy. High interest rates resulting in minimum monthly payments keeps you in this endless cycle of debt.
I don't know about you, Andrew, but I dread looking at my credit card statement every month. And I don't blame myself. Upstart can lift that weight off of my shoulders so that you can finally feel the relief of being free of credit card debt.
If you're carrying a huge credit card balance every single month, you're not the only one. High interest rates make it hard to pay off the debt. It's unfair, but Upstart is going to help. Upstart is the fast and easy way to pay off your debt with a personal loan, all done online. Whether it's paying off credit cards, consolidating high interest debt, or funding personal expenses, over 500,000 people have used Upstart to get a simple, fixed monthly payment.
And unlike other lenders, guys, Upstart looks at more than just your credit score. I mean, come on, there's more to it, all right? Like your income and employment history. This means they can offer smarter rates with trusted partners.
You can receive funds as fast as one business day after accepting your loan. With a 5-minute online rate check, you can see your rate up front for loans between $1,000 to $50,000. It's a lot.
Find out how Upstart can lower your monthly payment today when you go to upstart.com/badfriends.
That's upstart.com/badfriends. Don't forget to use our URL to let them know we sent you. Loan amounts will be determined based on your credit, income, and certain other information provided in your loan application. Oh, David Hornsby. You know who he is? Cricket from my God, from Always Sunny.
Yeah, he's hilarious. He plays a really weird character in this.
Funny, dude. He's one of those guys that will go the rest of his career working, doing funny shit, and then only at the very end you'll go, man, that guy was incredible. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
You know so many people
when they find him dead in a in a condo in
Sherman Oaks?
Yeah.
In his basement. I keep David Hornsby in my basement. Yeah.
David Hornsby is actually my wife.
Matthew Lillard's really good too. He's been a lot of good. I'm stuck on watching documentaries now because I've been sitting on so many planes and downloading Netflix. I tried to watch that Hillbilly Elegy. Have you seen that?
No.
Have you seen that? Did you guys see that?
Nope.
I can't do documentaries.
No. Hillbilly Elegy is a movie. I tried to watch that and I went right back to documentaries. You know what? Ron Howard directed it. It's Amy Adams and Glenn Close, yeah.
What I hate doing is I start watching like a series on Netflix and then you finish this like season 2, let's say, right? And you're like, oh man, I actually like that. And then you look it up and it goes, this was canceled 8 years ago.
Right.
You know, and it's, right. You know. And
that happens every time to me.
Yeah, I just watched the Shannara Chronicles.
What is that?
It's just kind of like elf, human, sci-fi fantasy show.
Uh-huh.
And it's so bad. Okay, like the acting and even the special effects are terrible, but it was addictive and I watched the whole thing. Then I looked it up and it was like, that's a no on season 3 because of bad ratings and terrible. And I was like, oh man.
We've lived that life together.
Who are you telling?
I just got a couple of residual checks from Showtime. It's so funny. Are they still showing I'm Dying Up Here?
Yes, because I'm tired of people sending us messages. Every other day I'm getting a message about like, oh, this is a great show. When is it coming back? Or I can't believe they canceled it. Really? You can't believe they canceled it?
We should continue the lie and just be like, it is coming back.
It's coming back.
We're coming back. 2024. We'll be right back.
Yeah.
Griff, address what's on your arm, by the way, because people.
I got an IV. I got a immune boost IV.
Drip, drip, drip.
I got a drip, drip. I like doing it. And I got a vitamin D shot in my booty.
Really? Why do they got to go in your booty?
That's what I always say.
Is that preference?
No, preference.
They're like armor your
booty.
It's
meaty.
And you're like, how big is the needle?
I make the same joke with the nurse every time. You got to take me to dinner first, girl.
How funny. She's autistic. She puts it down. She's like, okay. And you guys have to go to dinner.
I know, like, fuck. She's on the spectrum.
Have you ever had an IV, Rude?
Yeah, when I had dengue.
I'm sorry.
When you had dengue fever? You had fucking dengue fever.
I thought she was dating a black guy. I'm sorry. I got that dengue. Is that what the young kids are calling it?
You know about that dengue.
Oh, he got that dengue.
I go, you only like white guys. She's like, I like brown and dengue. Dark chocolate. When did you fucking get dengue fever?
In the Philippines.
Oh. Is that common to get?
Yeah.
What's going on there? Is it just like the wild, wild west there? That just...
Can you Google dengue fever? Like, I can't believe that's that common. People still get that?
Mm-hmm.
I know it's common in parts of the world, but I don't think you... You lived in a developed part of the Philippines, right? No?
Caused by dengue virus.
I'm so ignorant. It's just like caused by a mosquito bite, right?
Mm-hmm.
Or any kind of bug bite.
Ugh.
Mosquito bite.
But what does it make you do? It's very rare. Very rare. Oh, that's fewer than 20,000 cases in the U.S. Look internationally how rare it is, though. Everything is rare here. Like, international numbers must be huge. Africa, I think it's massive.
It says dengue fever international flights.
Holy shit. 100 to 400 million infections every year. Yeah. I think Africa gets dengue fever constantly. Go back to the last page because I want to see more about dengue fever. Were these all your symptoms? Is this what you felt? Fever, headache, muscle joint? Did you have like vomiting, diarrhea, all that stuff?
Yeah, and I had like weird red dots all over my body.
Wow. How long did it last?
2 weeks.
2 weeks.
Mm.
It's like you had Rona. You had dengue Rona. And what, did you lose weight?
Yeah.
Dengue diet. I'm on the dengue diet. I lost 7 to 10 pounds.
So let me get this straight.
How much did you lose?
400 million people a year. Is that what that said?
Yeah, around the world. Get it.
I know. So 400 million people around the world get that.
Yeah.
And we didn't shut down the world economy for it?
Okay. Okay. We'll be right back with Breitbart News with Eric Griffin. How many people die of dengue? Say that. Well, you know the number one killer in the world is?
Fat.
Diarrhea.
Mm.
More people die in Africa from diarrhea, from dehydration and diarrhea, from getting sick and they die.
Mm.
Look at this, though. How many people die of dengue every single year? Up to 400 million people get infected, 22,000 die. That's nothing.
Yeah.
How many people die from diarrhea?
You don't shut down the economy for 22,000.
I mean, maybe. Maybe in LA they would. How many people die from diarrhea yearly? Look at this.
You would shut clubs
staggering.
Down.
Staggering. 1.6 million people died from diarrhea. Go globally. Can you believe that?
Wow.
800,000 died from suicide. 405,000. Yeah, diarrhea.
What happens? Are you just on the toilet? But then you just like, you just like fall out? Like, what? I just don't get it.
Yeah, they die from slipping off the toilet, cracking their head on the fucking sink.
Oh, that would make sense. You get real slippery on the toilet.
No, it's insane.
Or no, you know how they die? Rushing to the toilet and they can't get their pants down and then they fall and they hit their head. That probably happens.
This is the most.
You never shit your pants?
No. Have you shit your pants?
Dude, I'm over 40. You shit your pants when you're over 40.
No. There's two people in here that are 40. Have you shit your pants, PD?
Nope.
Have you Fancy?
Let's define what is shitting
Thank
your pants.
You.
Okay.
Pants.
All right. Well, what's the definition of
shitting pants? No. What, you know what he just said?
Yes.
He just said, I have farted a few times. And maybe a little bit of
One
shit
time
has
I
come
was
out.
Drinking this man's blood, I farted.
He said a little shit has come out on a fart every now and then. That's what I mean.
Fancy.
I don't mean like I'm just sitting around and just like, you know what I mean? I'm like, oh my God.
You tooted and booted.
Yeah.
Wait a minute, Fancy. Did that happen to you? Did you squeeze out a little shartskis?
Yeah.
Ah.
I love the just the yeah.
Yeah. Where was it? When was it?
I was doing Bad Friends one day.
You were here?
Yeah. Listen, he is terrible at improv.
He is. Yeah.
Like
sometimes he's
like,
good.
Like literally he the scenario just turned into something completely.
Could I add a little bit to how bad he is at improv? I just started him some improv classes last night. Here's his improv. Hello, George, who has a wife and a kid. It is raining outside.
Did you really go to improv class, Fans?
I did.
You did?
Yeah.
What the fuck? How come we haven't talked? What did you go to improv?
Yeah, and why didn't you film that? Where was the camera crew for that?
Where did you go to? Did you do online?
No. It was in person.
Where?
It came. This coach came to us.
Oh. This sounds like some like that. That's how you end
did
up.
Did you hire a fucking improv coach?
I did.
Oh my God.
And where
God.
Did you find him though? Is he reputable? Because this seems like a
Craigslist.
Oh, okay.
Exactly.
Yeah.
It's where the best improvers yeah, are yeah, yeah. hanging out on Craigslist. Fancy, I'm proud of you for improving. That's great.
Yeah.
Good for you, Fans. Fuck yes. We do have to record that. George, next time we do have to record that, please.
Okay.
Yeah, there's no doubt.
Yeah, that is like, that's gold.
That's for this show. That's yeah. for this show.
And then bring that improv teacher on.
No. You know I'm not doing that shit.
Yeah, just no, zoom him in. It'll be like, tell us, and then have that guy do an improv class with you and Bobby. That would be hilarious.
He'd have to pay us, man. He'd have to pay us the big bucks. Speaking of which, Bobo called me when I was in Jersey. Where was I? Yeah, I was coming back from Jersey. Which, by the way, I did my last socially distanced show.
Mm-hmm.
They had me in the Hard Rock. We sold out both shows, 7,000-seat arena. Where fucking Kevin Hart plays, because they had to spread out all these chairs because it was booked before the final.
Oh.
I did the show on Sunday. On fucking Monday, they could have put it in the regular venue or whatever.
Oh,
but
no.
It had been booked during COVID.
Well, how many people were in there?
Each show was, I could actually look. Each show, I'm going to look right now, but bro, I walked
how did
in.
It look though? How did it feel?
I mean, dude, they did the best job that they could, but it was all so spread out.
Yeah.
It was how, yeah. I mean, it was like, it was a bummer because I was like, this was so spread out. So the total numbers was, it was like 1,200 people total. So 600 a show.
Damn.
I know, trust me, it was bananas. Dude, it was spread out.
I was just in Florida, West Palm Beach, and
yeah, it's fine.
You wouldn't even know.
No, I know. Well, I did same thing. I was in Dallas, same thing. They were shoulder to shoulder. But look, this had been booked before. That's what it was, but they were so spread out, man. Dude, honestly though, it was echoey and the gaps were huge and you were like, this is so it was tough, but on the way back, Bobo texted me and he said I think he said I'm on the verge. And then I said, "What?" And he said, "Call me." Hold on. So I called him, and he said, "This is Bobby. I'm on the verge." That's what he said. I said, "What?" He said, "Call me." He said he's having an emotional breakdown because no one wants to hang out with him. Such a fucking baby and a liar, bro. I'm FaceTiming him, and he's literally
no one wants to hang out with
that's
him.
That's what he says.
No, I think it's no one wants to enable his bullshit behavior. He's right. around like other actors and stuff like that who are like, dude. I don't listen to your podcast.
Jamie
Lee
Curtis.
That's what it is.
Here, let's see. Let's see if we can get him on FaceTime right now while he's in Hungary. He's only got a little bit of time left.
Oh, you got to give me
the mask. Oh, yeah, you should have had. Although I don't know where it is now. He's not going to pick up. But he called me and said no one wanted to hang out. Jamie Lee Curtis didn't want to hang out with him.
Yeah, I understandable. Get it.
But they went out to dinner like twice. And then after that, he's like, I'd have nothing to talk about. And I want to be in the same frame with these people. And I want to be as cool as these people. And Cate Blanchett is there, which is like.
Wow.
Can you believe that?
Yeah.
I can't. She's like, whatever the case may be. He was all complaining because no one would hang out with him because he was like, I'm alone all day long and all night. He's got one new friend on there. Has he talked to you about his friends out there?
He said that he had one friend, but then that friend left.
Yeah, the guy left.
I don't know why he didn't just like set up a show down there or something.
Yeah, but because he's lazy. I mean, what has he been doing? Has he told you what he's been doing?
Just in his room, eating.
Eating and playing video games. Yeah.
Oh, he brought his Xbox or PlayStation?
He's there for 9 weeks. You think he wasn't going to bring something?
Yeah, that's true.
What would he do?
I don't know.
I mean, he didn't like the food. He complained about literally everything. And then he complained that he's probably not going to get any billing and get cut out of the movie. And at some point, I hung up.
Yeah, cut two is going to have the funniest scene in the movie.
100%.
You know?
100%. So he's bitching and moaning and complaining.
It's going to be the dictator all over again.
Yeah, he called all angry about it. But yeah, but on my way back, I was saying how I'm happy that everything is lifted. I went to New York. And I was in the cellar. Have you ever done the cellar?
Yeah.
Are you past there?
Yeah, yeah. I when I did this movie with Ray Romano, I walked in with him.
And Esty was there?
Yeah, yeah. And it was kind of like, oh, you know. And then we got regular sets.
Right.
Because like he bumped it, you know.
Sure.
I went on with him. So it's funny. So I tell him, I go.
Well, you were doing what? Oh, the movie with Ray Romano. Oh, right.
So then he goes, let's come on Saturday too. And I say, Ray, why don't we tell her? And get like on the lineup.
Yeah.
So we're not, and he goes, oh, you know what? You're right.
He's so famous.
Yeah,
because
to him, he doesn't
shit.
Even, you know what I mean? So we did that, you know, they didn't put his name on the lineup. You know,
they put you on though.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Right.
And then I did it, and I think that after that, I think she was at that finally like, oh, okay, this guy's funny.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
I'd had no plans to. I had never done The Cellar. It kind of was one of those things where it's like, that's New York's Comedy Store.
Yeah.
Those guys come here, it's a little weird. We go there, it's a little weird. It's, you know, it's like their home. You know what I mean? I didn't want to step on toes, even though I knew a bunch of those guys.
Right, me too.
But DeStefano came out, and Chris was doing like six sets. You know, one at The Cellar, one at Fepa, Pussycat, one at Village Underground. And then he did that twice over. And then he said, do you want to go up? Esty would like to watch you. I said, dude, I've never played here, and I don't know. You know what's weird is like, I didn't know if I cared. If I was like, I'm not here enough.
Yeah, yeah.
I respect the place.
And even when you go, you're probably doing like a club. You're probably doing like Caroline's or some little theater.
Maybe,
because
I usually don't play New York. New York is so hard to play.
It really is.
I usually say no. I usually go, I'll play like Jersey. I'll play Philly,
New
Boston.
New York City's tough. It's a tough sell.
So anyway, blah, blah, blah. I said, all right, fine. I'll go, why not do a spot? And I knew people, Mateo Lane was there, who I love. He murdered. He's so funny, man.
Yeah.
Carmen Lynch, like people that I recognized that I knew, Todd Barry. It was like, all right, I was comfortable. You know, Ricky Velez, it was people I have known or seen before. And I went up and had a great set. And then she was like, anytime you want, da-da. But it was cool to get past at this age in our career because—
That's what I felt.
We don't do that anymore. You don't showcase it.
You like, just go, like, if you're not in at a club, you just go, well, I'm not in at that club.
I don't go there.
And I just won't go there.
But isn't it funny, dude, to do 5 minutes? I haven't done 5 minutes in, I don't know. I really can't. I genuinely, like, maybe 7, 8, 9 years. I don't know. When's the last time you did 5 minutes?
Oh, shit. I wouldn't even know how to do it.
It was genuinely hard.
You just kind of do it. You just kind of go, okay, I guess I got to get off.
Here's two jokes. Like, that's how I felt. I was like, here's two jokes.
I saw, did you see, was Louis there?
He had just been there in the early show. Yeah, because he's been going a lot.
Yes, yeah, I saw him perform, and I was like, all right.
Yeah, he's back in full swing. That club is back. They've got all the
They took the things down, right?
They just took them down. Yeah, yeah. The what are those? The plexiglass.
Yeah,
or whatever.
Yeah, yeah. But yeah, I didn't even feel like it wasn't a lot of people in there when I did it.
No, because it's packed.
But I'm saying because it's so small. Yeah. So I was like, damn. I wonder how it is. They probably just got people like sardines in that place. But it's a nice vibe in there.
Yeah.
It's the same kind of feeling I got. It's the same kind of OR feeling.
It feels like the ROR. Yeah, right. Yeah, yeah. Except it's more intimate. Bro, I've done a couple of sets and they've been fine, but it doesn't feel the same.
Yeah.
It also, not to get negative, but it doesn't feel the same without Jeff Scott at the piano. It's just a weird thing. It just felt sad. It felt a little weird for me.
I had forgotten when I first went.
You forgot that he died?
Griff. Not that I was looking for him.
Right.
What I'm saying though is like it was like a punch in the face reminder. So I looked over there and I was like, oh fuck, that's right.
And they have his name lit up there.
Yeah, yeah. So that was like, I thought that it's a nice tribute that they're doing that.
Yeah, I think I think I'm so excited. What, the 15th, everything is open up finally, right? Are you excited? What are you going to do first? Huh? What are you going to do first on the 15th when everything is open? No mask, no restriction.
She's going to go to the post office.
She's still nervous. Look at her.
Stay home.
You're still going to stay home?
Yeah.
You're vaccinated. You're fine.
Yeah, but I don't want to go anywhere.
Oh, my God.
This is the youth.
I know.
This is the youth. This is what happens.
What's a regular day for you, then?
Sleeping.
For real. That's all she does. What time are you sleeping until every day?
Like, was this like an annoyance to come here?
No.
Yes. Yes.
No.
She hates it here.
I love coming here.
She hates it here. Well, Rudy, you, what else are you doing during the day? Now the school's about to be, this is summertime, right?
No, I still have one more week.
Yeah, okay, one more week, I'm saying, but that you're done.
Yeah.
And then what are you going to do for the summer?
Maybe go back to Hawaii or in the Philippines.
See how fancy this is?
I know, fancy as hell.
Go to back to Hawaii? You know how many times I went to Hawaii when I was in high school? Zero. I didn't go to fucking Hawaii. I didn't get to go to vacation. We went to Florida.
Yeah.
To Florida.
To see your grandma.
Yeah, once.
Like,
yeah. To go sit by the beach and burn.
A
that's
terrible
what I got.
Trip.
Right. And by car, by the way, we used to have to drive to Florida.
I was a little more fancy actually, because I was the only child.
Yeah, it was just you and your mom.
Yeah, just me and my mom. So, when I was 7 years old, we went to like a tour. We went to London, Paris, and Rome.
Woo!
Yeah.
What did your mom do for a living?
I don't even remember those days.
You don't know what she was doing?
Yeah, well, she did so many different. Like, she became like, she went to school to become something different, and then like, so in my later years, she was a safety specialist for the city,
she worked for LA, the city?
Yeah, like one of the colleges downtown. So she was like the safety spec, because it became this, because people were, you know what it was? It was a new profession. People were getting sued. Companies were getting sued so often for workers' compensation that they came up with like a profession to help companies stop, you know, make sure there was fire extinguishers, make sure there was like, oh, so she became a safety specialist. But she was like a transcriber when I was a kid.
Really?
Yeah.
She did like 1,000 different things.
Yeah.
She
so never like, the transcribing was a big thing for her. So, because like there was no, if you think about now, like, so a doctor would like, you know, be in this thing that, you know, at surgery or whatever, or talking. And then she would like be a medical transcriber. So then she would have to like, you know, type whatever the doctor said.
Wow.
You know, but now it's like, they don't, like, that kind of profession's gone. Like take like a photo mat.
Right. It's all uploaded.
You know what I mean? Like, you could just like do voice, you voiced, you know.
Right. The moment you say it, it's already logged in.
Yeah.
Raycon. Oh my God. You know what, man? You know, I've been using, you know, before I discovered Raycons, just standard earbuds and stuff to listen to music. But once I discovered Raycon, I just threw all the other stuff away.
Well, you don't need it anymore. And I got to tell you, if you're traveling, if you're starting to travel right now because the world is opening back up and you want something to listen to, throw those Raycons in your ears and listen to the sound, man.
You can get crisp, powerful beats at half the price of other premium auto brands.
Yeah, they look and feel better. They come in a range of colors, which I love because I'm so tired of having just good old-fashioned white for some reason. I like some flavor in my ear.
Yeah, and Raycons are built to go wherever you go with quick and seamless Bluetooth pairing and a compact charging case.
Yeah, they also have 24-hour battery life and portability. You can take them literally everywhere. You like to run with them. Bob likes to have them when he's on an
airplane.
You take them on an airplane.
My airplane.
I take them when I go for a run.
Listen up.
Raycon's offering 15% off all their products for our listeners, and here's what you got to do to get it, Bob. What do you got to do?
You got to go to buyraycon.com/badfriends.
There you'll get 15%
off. You get 15% off your entire Raycon order, and it's such a great deal.
It is.
You'll want to grab a pair and a spare. Close it out, Andrew.
That's 15% off at buyraycon.com/badfriends. Buyraycon.com/badfriends.
Keeps.
Hey, man.
Andreas.
Andreas, the fancy.
This is for you, baby.
Well, yeah.
Andreas, two out of three men will experience some form of hair loss by the age of 35. And this right here, this service is the best for you, man. More than 50 million men in the U.S. suffer from male pattern baldness.
That's a lot.
And there are only two FDA-approved medications that can prevent hair loss, and Keeps offers both, Andreas.
Look, we're all thinning as we get older, baby, and Keeps is offering a simple, stress-free way to keep your hair convenient. Virtual doctor consultations and medications delivered straight to your door every 3 months. You're not going to leave your home. It comes in a discreet package, so no one knows. Don't freak out. It's also low cost. They start at just $10 a month, and they offer generic versions as well, and prevention is key. If you're losing your hair, jump on it now.
Keeps has more 5-star reviews than any of its competitors.
That's right. If you're ready to take action and prevent hair loss, go to Keeps, KEEPS.com/badfriends to receive your first month of treatment for free. That's Keeps, KEEPS.com/badfriends to get your first month free. Keeps.com/badfriends, KEEPS.com/badfriends. Well, like, I saw that commercial the other day about the Motorola. I know you guys have probably seen this. They're pushing this deaf guy is talking to his son for the first time because you can speak and it dictates what you're saying. So you can be on the phone, right, with someone who's deaf, and you can be speaking like you're speaking to them, and it will voice dictate everything that you say.
That shit don't work good, though.
Bro, he was like, he's like, Dad, do you realize it's the first time we've talked, or that we've talked over the phone, and I'm such a dick that I'm just like, he still can't hear him.
Yeah.
You're not talking over the phone.
No, but it's like you're
reading over the phone.
That voice texting shit, like, it's always going to mess up. So they're going to have a conversation.
I use it every day.
Yeah, but it doesn't. You always say something. You know what you
watch?
Let me tell you something.
Let me see if
let
it
me
works.
Say something that you always say in your voice texting. You
what?
Have to say this at least once in the chain. Huh. Sorry about that. I'm voice texting.
Right. Here, watch. Let's see if I can do this. Hey, Griff, I'm voice texting you right now, and I'm pretty sure that every single thing that's coming out of my mouth is going to be correctly put on this app.
You fucked up.
So. I know. I didn't know what to say. I'm voice texting right now. I'm pretty sure that everything
is Griffin,
coming out of
my mouth. Hey, Griffin, my cock is so big.
Hey!
Right now, and I'm pretty sure that every single because you said you didn't say anything.
No, it's if you
said all this
with,
enunciating, like, you, that was so simple.
So I speak with clarity.
Hi, hello, how are you doing? This is Andrew texting you right now. That's that. When you start like talking
I'll do it the way that
you know
I'm
what?
Supposed
just,
to do it.
Just
I'll
turn
do
it the
way
right
I'm
now. No, stop it. Just do it like this right now. Like, just turn it on.
Oh, yo, what's up, Griff? You know I'm out here doing my thing, dog. that hey man, it got in there. See?
Maybe it's like set to just like listen. White people register.
White people register, yeah. Well, it was made by Asians who only like whites.
See, look, I'm going to send you what you just said. It says, it was made by an agent who only like white.
That's because that phone is stopped. That's trying to stop Asian hate. That's what that is. Speaking of agents, are you on a job hunt now?
Yeah.
Sorry. I haven't had an audition in 3 years. I'm dead serious.
Yeah, well, even the one audition I got all my hopes up, and then they didn't even...
I know. I told you I thought it was going to get picked up, and I'm sorry that it didn't.
But you know what, dude? Can I tell you something? Can I just give you what a network television is like?
Listen up, Rudy. This is for you.
This is for you. All right. So let's say, Rudy, let's say you have a lot of money, and you want to build a house, and you hire an architect, and the architect draws out everything about the house, and you go, I love this house. Mm-hmm. That's the house I want you to make. And in the making of the house, you start going like this. I think I want the kitchen on the other side. You know what? Can you change the... You're using mahogany. I want you to use a different wood. And then you make all these changes, and then you see your house, and then you go like this. I don't like this. Yeah, bitch. You know why you don't like it? You know why you don't like it, network? Because you fucked it up. That's why you don't like it now. Because all your dumbass changes.
ABC.
ABC? They fucking fucked it up. And then they want to wonder why they don't like it. You know why you don't like it? Because you got involved. You should just write checks and let talented makers of entertainment do the thing you paid them for. It's unbelievable.
I know.
That's what they ruin things.
You can say that. I'm not saying that. I'm not getting any work. You can. That's you.
I'm not getting any work either. Then that's the last time I'm working for them anyway.
Now. Yeah, that's it. Disney's.
Then I saw the pilot, you know,
was
and then like
bad?
My section, like, you know, they cut it down so much. I was like, do you even like me? Did you even really want me in this show?
Was the pilot bad?
It wasn't what I thought. I was so disappointed in what they did to the Office part of the show that I was like, I wouldn't have picked this up either. That was my thought.
Who was the star of the show?
Shannon Woodward, Jane Lynch.
Jane Lynch is...
She was great. The show was touching.
Shannon Woodward?
Yeah.
I don't know who that is. Am I stupid?
Look her up. She was on West... If you saw her, she was on Raising Amy. Or Raising Hope. Not Raising Amy. Her name's Amy on the show.
Oh, yeah, I like her.
Yeah, she's great.
Westworld, yeah.
Westworld. And she was so good at the role she was playing. Like just, you know. And I feel bad because the creator of the show, this was like her life story, sort of. You know, it was based off her own story. Oh. She's been working on it for 5 years. You finally get your show made. And you then, get it going. And then they just go, see ya.
Yeah, they do what Andres does in his fucking pants. That's so sad. That's so sad that those things come and go so much.
I know.
They never have given a chance.
That's what I'm saying. Like, it's like, why don't you just let these people make the show they wanted to make? And then if you say, after you see it, you go, well, we don't like it. But they're so involved at every step of the way, and they wonder why they don't like it.
Right.
That's my point.
The way I think is everything should be shot 3 episodes. I think pilots, quote unquote, should be 3 episodes, because you can't really get to know something in the first episode. By the second and third, you really get a rhythm.
You're spending so much money anyway. Why not?
Just do 3. To me, 3 is the golden number. What do you think, Vance? You're in the industry.
I'm just... You can see how upset I am.
I know. Well, you should be.
Although, I think the way they're doing it today with platforms is better. If they like something, they just
greenlight
the whole system.
But that's true. But on network still doesn't apply. They don't do it that way.
Right.
They still do the pilot system, which is they pick up, you know, they shoot 10 pilots or
but
five.
They
or...
nitpick at every single stage.
Well, who
of
was
it?
The studio and who was the network?
ABC Signature Studio and ABC Network.
Oh, so that should have been a lot. Usually, it's really tough if it's like Fox Studios and NBC Network, and you're like, oh my God. This is, you have two competing brands.
Yeah.
That's the weirdest thing. It's like Nike and Adidas have a contract with an athlete.
I know.
That's what it's like, which doesn't exist.
But people think.
Imagine they're both going to go.
People think that about TV. People think that.
Right.
People think that, like, when ABC show is on ABC, you go like, no, that ABC show's on CBS.
Right.
They don't, you don't even know, because there's probably like really only 3 studios in the entire world. Like, they're all subsidiaries of something else.
Right.
The network television is about selling refrigerators.
Yes.
It's not about entertainment.
It's why The Price is Right literally was about buying shit.
Yeah.
It was literally like, how much is this thing we're actually promoting? That's what it was.
Like, they make a show, and then the upfronts are all about showing these shows to the advertisers. Because the advertisers are like, okay, is that show funny enough where people are going to watch it so we can, you know, sell our products?
Right.
That's what it's all about.
Right.
So you have to understand, like, why they don't care about racial equality.
Thank God.
They don't care about none of this stuff. All they care about is, like, how many white homes that got a lot of money can we get these shows into?
Correct.
And this is why you see a lot of white TV. It's not like, it's not necessary. Like, we need to stop always assuming that this is about race. Mm. It's about money. As a person of color, when I'm looking at this shit and I'm like, they don't got no black people on. No, because when they do, it'll be like, it's a black show for black advertisers. That's why when you're watching a black show, the McDonald's commercial was always, what up, y'all?
They're always like that.
Big Mac, you know?
They've been like that for 15 years.
I know, but you don't see that on. That ain't on Grey's Anatomy. When you watch Grey's Anatomy,
there's
it's
no
white as
there's
hell.
No McDonald's on Grey's Anatomy.
You know what I mean?
The Chick-fil-A.
Like, anytime, and they do that, and what I'm saying is, I actually understand the business of it.
Well, it's just business.
It's just business.
Yeah, but I'm also like, I think, for me, no matter, I think we should be more diverse. I like the diversity that's coming and happening.
Yeah, of course.
But the thing I don't like is, if the diverse stories are the same stories all the time.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
So you're like, make sure that this is a broad range of shit.
Yeah, yeah.
You know what show was kind of wild and totally different was,
Have you seen Bo Burnham's new Netflix special? Everyone keeps talking about it, and I want to watch it, but I think it's one of these, like, alternative type, you know.
What are you laughing at, George? Like, you hear George chuckling. Piece. What like are you chuckling about, so George?
I want to check it out.
Yeah, it is one of these alternative types of things. It's not that funny, but it's very interesting.
Yeah, see, that's what I'm hearing. So then it's going to be labeled brilliant.
What does that even mean, George? Explain that.
Well, I think there's no audience.
I May Destroy You was the show I was trying to think of. I couldn't think of her name. Do you know that show?
No.
Yeah, you like it, don't you? See, this is my point is like...
Watchmen was good.
I like when it's non-white bullshit anymore. Mm-hmm. I like when non-white creators are making super unique shit because I think even when they do submit stuff for the most part, it gets channeled into this like... I know, but can you make an Atlanta? You know what I mean? Like they, do you know what I'm saying? That's my biggest beef.
Yeah,
I agree. They're pushing out the same shit. So
yeah.
So at least that show's good, isn't it? I May Destroy You is wild.
It comes across.
You should watch it.
It comes across as if
it's fucking funky.
Not to say that this is true, but it comes across as if the white production side, they get to like live their dreams and like let's make whatever we want to make, and then we'll see if it works.
Right.
And on the other side, it has to be like something they know.
Well, it has to be something they're familiar with culturally, because otherwise,
or some white guy has to take a chance on someone like Atlanta,
Issa Rae, or
yeah. They take a chance. They go, yeah. Let's do this, and then you see this. You know, what I love about Insecure is like you feel like you're a fly on the wall to these black women's lives.
Yeah,
you know, and it's just like you just go, oh, and then they're portraying them as like powerful, successful, but also sexual creatures that like
humans,
like human beings. You know, because when I come from an era of the 80s and stuff where, like, if you saw a black woman in a movie or TV, she got to be sassy as hell. She got to be, like, you know. Ghetto.
Yeah.
You know, whatever it is like
don't
that.
Don't make me.
Yeah. Not, they're never portrayed as people that, like having sex or like doing things.
Or just being like
a normal person.
Yeah,
like,
they always inflate these caricatures.
Yeah, and so then when you watch Insecure, you're just like, oh shit, this is like, you know.
Yeah, they're modern day women. That's what I May Destroy You is kind of like. That's why you'd like that show. No, but what were you saying? You were saying before that there was a show. You were just saying. What did you just say before that? What did he say?
Who? Hacks? Oh, he's had a... Oh, no, we talk about Bo Burnham's thing.
Oh, yeah. So tell me about Bo's special.
I haven't seen it, but this is one of those things that, like, the, you know, the what's that one, like, real woke, artsy, like, the Verge or whatever.
Sure.
One of those publications where it has to be like, oh, this is the most genius thing I've ever, you know. It's
is
like,
that what they said?
Yeah, that's that kind of thing you're getting. That's the kind of publicity it's getting, so I want to check it out.
Look, I'm sure
he's an artsy-fartsy kid. He's always been like that.
Yeah, it's how he became famous.
Yeah.
I think he's crazy talented. I mean, there's a song. That song he put out, "Art Is Dead," is one of the best songs I've ever heard. Do you ever hear that song?
No.
"Art Is Dead" is so good. Just pull up the lyrics.
I met him when I was doing my New Faces in Montreal.
When he was like 16.
Yeah, he was like 16, 17, saying like crazy shit on stage. But he's always been like,
look at how powerful this is, though. This next song is honestly about nothing at all, but it helps me sleep at night. "Art Is Dead." "Art Is Dead." "Art Is Dead." Entertainers like to seem complicated, but we're not complicated. I can explain it pretty easily. Have you ever been to a birthday party for children and one of the children won't stop screaming because he's a little attention attractor? When he grows up to be a comic or actor, he'll be rewarded for never maturing, for never understanding or learning that every day can't be about him. There's other people, you selfish asshole.
Is this about Bobby?
But truly, All of this money you worked very hard for. I slept in late while you worked at the drugstore. My drug's attention. I'm an addict, but I get rewarded. I get paid to indulge in my habit. It's all an illusion. I'm wearing makeup. It's great, man. It's great. I'm doing it. No justice, by the way. But what my point is, like,
well,
it's
directed a couple specials.
It's a
already.
Deep, it's a deep, wonderful song about what it's like to be a comic. I think he has good internal struggle.
I think that this special is portraying those things.
That's great.
I, my only problem with these like alternative specials,
they're
is,
not traditional.
Let's
you
not
like
call them that. Let's
right.
Not, I'm just saying. Let's call it. Let's make a new thing.
Well, it's called. It's
let's
not,
make
it's
a
called
new
a
category.
Comedy special.
Well,
right?
No, because even in, back in the day when you saw like. They would call them one man shows, one woman shows.
Right.
You know, and you knew you weren't watching a comedy special.
That's true.
You were watching a different piece of art.
Yeah.
So what I don't appreciate is that now they're doing these things and then shitting on the people that go the art form of going on stage and
just doing stand up.
And just doing stand up as if like, oh, well, this isn't enough.
Right.
It's like, what are you talking about?
Two totally separate things.
They're two totally separate things.
Right, I know. But
and I don't like that.
But the problem is now with like her, the youth, like her age range, they weren't used to that. So like all they're used to now is categorically a TikTok guy is a comedian. Do you know what I'm saying? Like it's be-
no.
The lines are blurred.
Okay. I hear what you're saying.
Yeah.
But I disagree as that being the reason.
What is it?
No, they are used to it. They just don't like it because it sucks. I mean, straight up.
Yeah.
Like, listen to me. You go on Netflix mm-hmm. and you look how many comedy specials they have on there.
Yeah.
They suck.
A good amount of them.
A good amount of them just suck. The ones that are good, they stand out. You know, it's hard to make a, it's a hard thing to achieve.
Yeah.
It ain't even about the person not being funny or whatever. It's just about, it's hard to capture what happens in a live show.
It's impossible.
So, and then they were just handing out specials like candy. It didn't even matter. Are you the most famous person in Guatemala? Well, you're getting a special. Are you the most famous person in fucking whatever? Pick a country in Europe.
Right.
Well, we're going to give you a special. And they just were like inundating these young people with like all this stuff.
Right.
Every network, Showtime, HBO, Netflix, Amazon. And they just were like, and so now, you know, if I was young now, you'd be like, why do they call it special?
Mm-hmm. Because it's not anymore.
Cause it's not, so I don't think it is anything to do with like they're not used to it. They're just like, oh, that's that thing that they do that no one likes or watches.
The problem is comedy is so hard to capture.
Yes, it is.
So inherently, specials are tough.
Yeah.
Like they really just have to be a moment in time. That's why like Eddie's shit was great because it was a moment in time.
Yeah.
Right?
He's also a phenomenal performer.
It also goes
to the comic themselves.
It was a
too.
Moment in time. Shit was happening. It was like an amalgamation of like, he is just becoming mega famous. He's a great writer. He's a great performer. He's just becoming globally famous. Like, that was just, timing was a perfect. Same with Chappelle. Timing was perfect for Dave.
Yeah, but I don't even know if it has.
That's how a great special is born.
But
it's like the timing is perfect.
But with him, though, I mean, what's the timing of six specials? I just think that.
No, I'm saying when they first crack, the first specials
the reason
that they crack is because. You know, like Sebastian didn't pop until his fourth special or whatever.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
But that's because the timing wasn't right for the early ones. He wasn't that he wasn't funny. He was funny. But we're all funny. Everyone that's good enough is professional. You're funny.
Yeah.
You'll go rip a room anywhere. The special, the idea of a special, it's why Bobby won't make one, which I agree with. Because it's so hard to capture what you really want to put down forever.
And you have to have material, you know.
I love giving you layups.
That was like,
boom, off the backboard. He broke the glass.
No, but it is.
Have you ever watched comedy specials?
I've seen Joe Coy's.
Joe Coy, right. That, of course.
Of
yeah,
course.
Who else would she see?
And by the way, and that's why Netflix does that.
Right. Right. He looks like you.
Yeah.
Do you like this guy that looks like you? How did you like Joe Coy's special?
It was funny. I liked it.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Have you ever seen anybody else's?
John Mulaney's.
Right, you like John Mulaney. We talked about that. And you know he's not single anymore.
Well, he looks like an older version of the guy she likes. So she's seeing like, ooh, my guy's going to end up looking like this.
John Mulaney's like a tall, skinny puppet.
Yeah.
What do you mean? That guy looks like a young
they all start
sex
like
machine.
That. They all start
John
like
Mulaney
that.
Did not look like that
they
at any point.
They start like that, and they turn into a fucking monster.
Ventriloquist?
Yeah.
No, no, he does not look like those young guys. No, but so you've seen Mulaney's and you've seen Joe Coy's. That's it, huh?
Trevor Noah.
Oh, okay. What'd you think about that?
I liked it.
You did, huh? Okay.
How you really feel, Andrew?
I didn't say anything. I just said you did.
Andrew's about to call George. Take that out. Take that part out.
No. I've only seen one thing he's ever done. I don't know.
What I'm saying is there's so many.
Yeah, there's too many.
There's too many.
Yeah, there is too many. And you know what? It's all going to stop now.
Oh, wait, because listen.
It's over now.
Netflix cornered the market. They overpaid for comedy, so people will walk down the street and go, hey, do you have a special on Netflix?
Mm-hmm.
That's why they did that. So they own it now. It used to be HBO. Remember how HBO used to be the thing?
They were the
biggest. We were coming up. We were like, I want to get an HBO special. That was the dream of every comic. Now it's like, I don't even know. I don't even know what the dream is anymore as a comic.
I think the dream is just to continue. You know, Jay Leno.
The dream is to go viral. That's the dream.
The dream is just to create a big fan base and have them go to see you live.
That's what I'm saying. That's right. Yeah. The same thing.
But I'm saying it's not about, that's good now because now you can try to continue to make your own shit.
Oh, well, because, because now it's like, you know, we need it. Okay, before.
I want people to see me live. That's all I really want. But, come see me live and have fun with me.
But I'm saying before there was only certain outlets in entertainment. So you had to go that route.
Right.
So that's why it seemed as if, well, you got to work this hard to get like a sitcom, to get a special.
Right.
But now, look, you could be a funny Christian comic who got a million followers and you making $500,000 a year.
More.
And those kids
are selling out arenas.
I mean, I'm saying it's crazy. So there's a niche market for, there's that, even that guy, what's his name? Darren Criss or whatever his name is, Country Mama or
I don't know who that is.
Mama Country or whatever the hell his name. The guy that got clowned
At Just for Laughs.
At Just for Laughs.
Southern Mama, is that it?
Southern Mama, that's him.
Darren Knight.
Darren Knight.
Images, obviously. I don't want to see a video.
I knew his name was Darren.
Yeah, he did Just for Laughs with us.
This guy's huge.
Well, right, what did we do? He came to Just for Laughs. He was a
look up his net worth. He's huge.
He was on the Comics to Watch, right? Variety. When you and I were together. Well, I mean, this is one of the many years that we were there, but like I remember he did his gala, right? And he bombed and he went home because it didn't go well, right? Like he freaked out.
No, this was like he was on stage criticizing the other comics.
Oh, he was?
Yeah.
Oh, I just heard he bombed.
And then they confronted him in the hallway. Chris Redd was like going in on him in the hallway.
Because he was talking shit.
He just, what he was saying, you know, the stuff he was saying, like, you know, like.
Net worth, $2 million is wrong. Yeah. That's what, these things, by the way, zoom in on that website real fast. Punch in on that website. Just pinch and pull. Pinch your fingers. Oh, Jesus, George. Go back. You know how you can just pull your fingers on that? There you go. Look at the website that we try to verify. Glooby Gang Official. Yeah, that's who we're going to take.
You don't go there from like. But anyway, the guy makes so much money. I know it because he's like on Facebook too. So what I'm saying though is like, and it's no knock on him. What I'm saying is like he has his following.
Yeah, no. Yeah, that's what you need to create. That's,
you know,
it.
So now we're in a situation where you don't need. Like sometimes I'm on Instagram and I'm like, I had lunch with this kid the other day. His name is Simi. Oh man, I forget how to say his name. But anyway, he's like, he's rolling with these like Nelk Network.
Boys.
Yeah.
I know who they are. Yeah.
He rolls with them.
Yeah.
Dude, these people, they sold like $60 million in merch last year.
I know. Yeah.
They got like, you know, and this kid's like, he's got 2 million followers. He's so huge on the internet. You know, he wants to be a comic. So that's why I met with him. And I was like, well, you got to go to open mics, man. You know what I mean? Like go to like, you know.
Or just tour. Who cares?
But that's what I said to him too. I said, if you want to
let him go do his own thing.
You want to set it up, you know, but I was like, it's amazing. Like, it's amazing how we're now in a day and age where you could have your own fan base that no one has to know anything about.
Right.
You know what I mean?
Yeah, you can live in your own little
lane. You have your own
lane.
It's
nice.
It's really amazing.
Well, it's nice.
It's an amazing time. So,
are you touring, by the way?
I told him to, like, let's start getting some stuff going.
You got to get out.
Yes, I just went to West Palm Beach. I'm in Austin this week, but I'm going for this
movie.
What
are you doing to Austin?
The movie that Bobby and I did together is called Hero Mode. Mm-hmm. It's coming out. So it's like, I'm going to the premiere and do like Q&A.
In Austin?
Yeah. But I saw a review of the movie and it was not good.
Is that it right there?
Yeah. I saw this review of the movie and they said like, oh, there was this cringy line in the movie. And I was like, oh, I think that's my line.
What was the line?
I forgot what it was, but I was like, I'm pretty sure that was my line. So it's like, I don't know. We'll see.
Hero Mode. What do you do in the movie?
I'm a teacher.
What does he do?
Bobby's the principal of the school.
Oh, so annoying.
Can you even imagine?
What a terrible film. It's going to be bad if you both are in it together.
Yeah.
All right, what is it?
So, we're doing a game in which both of you are playing the other person.
Okay.
So, you have to be like Eric, and Eric has to be like you.
Oh, no.
Oh, shit.
Oh, I gave me. Here we go, everybody.
Here we go. All right, let's do it.
So, okay, let's go.
What do you think is your best and worst quality?
My best quality is my loyalty, and my worst quality is probably my stand-up.
Oh, we gonna go that way.
Okay.
Okay.
All right, bro. I said loyalty up front.
I like how he like you turned it. You know, he was like, let me start sweet.
It's
and then
a
I'm
fucking
go.
Comedy show.
Okay.
All right, go ahead.
What kind of things will you be doing 10 years from now?
Oh. In
Are you me?
Yeah, I'm you now.
Okay.
Yeah, okay.
All right, and what will you be doing in 10 years, Santino?
You'll be fighting off skin cancer because the sun really affects my.
Yeah, we get it, bro. Can I answer that one for Griff?
I'll be
here. I'll be Eric. Ask me again. I'm Eric. Go ahead.
The Asian baby we're gonna adopt. it'll be like 8 years old by then.
She's 19. All right, what is it? Okay, say the question.
So. Eric,
yeah.
What kind of things will you be doing in 10 years?
Oh, this. You old ass bitch. All right, go ahead.
Terrible.
Rudy gets to answer. I'm going to be Rudy, and then Rudy gets to be Eric. I'll be Rudy.
Well, she should
Rudy.
Be Bobby, since he's not here.
Yeah, but it's got to be traded off with someone in this room.
Oh.
So I'll be Rudy, and then Rudy will be Eric. Yeah, so ask me, I'm Rudy.
Okay. Hey, Rudy.
Mm. Yes.
What is your perfect weekend?
Sleep. balut. more slip with the dogs.
Slip, slip, slip.
Okay. Go ahead, Rudy. Okay. Now you're Eric.
Well, she's got to be you. That's unfair. Look how you let himself off the hook.
No, you're Eric.
Yeah, Rudy, you're Eric.
I'll be him on this question. Don't
okay.
worry.
What is the strangest dream you have ever had?
Uh-oh.
The strangest dream.
Hey.
Hey, what are you doing?
The bottom's a turtle island.
Don't let him influence you.
That's what he likes. He wants to see a bunch of sex scenes.
Is Bobby, I'm with Bobby mm-hmm. and Santino mm-hmm. in an island, mm-hmm. naked, mm-hmm. and we're just doing things with each other.
Yeah. Okay. That is your little dream, isn't it?
What sort of things? What sort of things are we doing?
See, he's into it.
What sort of things?
All right.
Are we
you
eating?
Know
are we at the buffet line? Like,
you
what
know
are we
what?
Doing?
This was great. You did great. Rudy, I'm glad you're back. Eric, I'm glad you're black.
Ish.
Fine. Thank you. Thank you, Eric. I want you to end the show. Look in the in your single and say thank you for being a bad friend. You'll take us out.
All right. Hey, thank you for being a bad friend.
Perfect. Well, he's like, oh,
let's create a horror movie right now.
Okay.
What are you afraid of?
What am I the most afraid of?
Yeah, that's. I think we should play on our fears, right?
Yeah.
First of all, you and I are both. If we were going to write a horror movie,
yeah.
Figure out what our fears are, right? And then we'll just try to wrap a movie.
Okay, middle of nowhere stuff creeps me the fuck out. Mm. Like I'm always down for middle of nowhere films. I'm always like, ooh, it's so sketchy.
Okay, middle of nowhere. Complete, so like in the woods,
but in the mountains, in the woods,
in the mountains and woods,
even
okay.
more dangerous, right? Where yep. you can lose power. Yeah. It can be cold.
Yeah.
Right. So
mine has to do with the ocean.
Okay, so on a mountain over the ocean, we got there.
Yeah. But just being in the middle of the ocean. So.
Oh, okay, we're going to put it on a boat then.
No, we'll do both.
No, but listen, middle of nowhere is the middle of the ocean to me.
Okay.
One and the same.
Right.
So
how about one where it's on an island? But is that...
Islands are wonderful. What a great place to be haunted.
Okay, a haunted island.
A haunted island.
Right.
Perfect. Perfect.
Perfect. Then here's another thing that I'm afraid of, being buried alive.
Everyone. That's everyone's fear.
That's everyone's fear. What is an... kids?
I've got it. You and I wake up. You and I, okay. It you
okay.
starts on you,
right?
Sand is in your mouth. You climb out.
Yeah, yeah.
You were buried alive, right?
So what you're saying is that I'm a guy, right? How about this? Let me just create my character. I'm a guy, right?
Yeah.
And I work at like a liquor store in New York.
Correct.
Okay.
In Harlem.
So yeah, I'm logging out. I'm closing the store. It's not a 24-hour place, right?
Right.
So I'm locking everything up, right? And it just shows me like just walking with my backpack to my little squalor house.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
I live in the basement somewhere.
In Chinatown.
What?
You live in Chinatown.
Okay. Anyway, I'm Chinese.
It just feels right.
All right, I'm Chinese.
For this movie, you're Chinese.
Yeah. I'll be Chinese for this.
I'll be black in the movie.
We'll rewrite it. Yeah.
You live in the basement of a Chinese food store.
And then it just shows me like a little montage of me like cooking some ramen, right? Putting some ramen in, right?
Rat runs by, right?
And a really rickety table,
yeah.
Right? Sitting there, I'm slurping on the ramen. I'm watching something on TV, the news or something, mm-hmm. Right?
Rabbity or TV,
right? And then there's a cut scene where I'm just kind of reading a book on a mat. That's where I sleep.
On the floor?
Yeah.
Oh, sad. This guy is so sad.
So sad, right? And then I plug in my iPhone, whatever. I have a phone, right?
Samsung. Samsung.
Okay. Gotta be Samsung? All right, Samsung. I plug in my Samsung.
Chinatown.
Right.
Yeah.
Does it matter what kind of TV I'm looking at? Or
Toshiba. Toshiba.
Yeah.
A tube TV, no less. Right. Like an old tube, not a flat screen.
So I assume just by your thinking, correct. I'm wearing a kimono.
100%. What else would you be wearing at your house?
So just, all right.
Out in public, you have street clothes.
Kimono, I have a sword.
A sword. And your hair is in a bun. Must be. And what's in it? What's holding your hair up?
Chopsticks,
that's correct.
Oh, you racist fuck. All right.
Let's get back to where we want to be.
All right. For some reason, I'm wearing regular clothes.
You're wearing regular clothes at the liquor store.
But when I get home, there's got even montage where I put the kimono on. I put the chopsticks in my hair.
People will love it.
People love it. I have Samsung, Toshiba.
Samsung phone or Toshiba
TV. TV, right?
Right.
Oh shit!
Okay,
right.
Okay, so you're slurping your noodles. Right. Then you lay on your mat.
I lay on my bamboo mat.
Your bamboo mat.
Bamboo mat. Right.
Yeah.
Right. And then I wake up.
Right.
On an island.
You wake up. It's crawling out of sand.
Crawling out of sand.
Yes. Naked. Butt naked.
Butt naked.
Yeah.
Right. How about? I still have the chopsticks in my hair.
Oh, you got it. Yeah. Because we need to have you have materials to use.
Yeah.
Right.
For some reason, I still have the bun.
Perfect.
With the chopstick in my hair. Right. I come out. Right.
Yes.
Oh, and you're completely naked, right?
And it's the brutal day of this. It's the sun. It's bright.
Right.
And all
of a sudden, your character, mm-hmm. digs out, right? And you're wearing like a green suit. Like a leprechaun.
And where my penis is a little pot of gold. A little tiny pot of gold with coins spilling over.
So you're wearing a leprechaun costume. Okay.
All right, how about this? Look, okay.
Oh, shit.
Okay.
All
of the bullshit aside,
right.
We both wake up on the island.
Okay,
we're both butt naked. We wake up on the island. And you and I are ready to fight because we don't know how this happened. Did you do this to me?
Like, no, of course that's not going to. We're both coming out of holes. I'm not going to go.
But I thought.
Did you put me in this hole, bury me, and then put a hole, you put yourself in a hole and bury yourself?
Yes.
No.
That's the logic.
That's not the logic.
So we jump out of the hole.
Yeah, we jump out of the hole.
We're
right?
freaked out. We're
of
panicked.
Of course we are.
We had no idea what's going on. Where are we?
You always say something like, who are you?
Who are you?
Yeah, you're right. That's the dialogue. Who are you? You're right. And we kind of calm down. We try to calm down. I go, all right, so my name is Yoshi. Am I Yoshi?
Yoshi.
Yoshi, right?
And I'm?
Yeah.
Lucky.
Lucky. I'm not Yoshi.
I'm Lucky.
Yeah. Do we have to have accents?
For this, we should.
I'm a Yoshi.
I'm Lucky.
I'm Yoshi.
I'm Lucky Yoshi.
Doing? What are we doing here? Okay, so in this island, it's not a big island.
Very small.
It's maybe, what, a half a mile around?
Not even. Quarter mile around.
Quarter mile Very around, small. Right? But there is, in the middle of the island, is dense. There's trees and
thick.
One. Thick.
Very thick.
But there is a path.
Right.
Right? You and I... You go. It's so hot out here.
We have to get.
We have to get covered.
I'm gonna get sunburned.
You're almost not in flames.
I'm done.
Right. And I go. All right. So let's. I found a trail. We go on the trail. In the middle of this island is a statue of her. her eyes are black.
Black.
Right? And there's red blood tears.
Right there.
Right, blood tears. Right? And obviously she has knives.
To
and
the distance.
There's like a little message underneath.
What does it say? I can't read it.